Hello and welcome to Forever Rugby on Forever Sports. And an absolutely scintillating encounter has just transpired in Johannesburg. The Lions bouncing back to a bonus point victory over the Western Province despite an almost epic comeback in the last stages of the game after the Lions received two yellow cards. 38 points to 32 was the final scoreline. A brilliant result for the side from Johannesburg and an incredibly incredible performance up until about the 68th minute from a side who looked like they didn't even deserve to be in the Currie Cup or the United Rugby Championship on Friday. After being actually taken apart by the Pumas, this Lions side really did turn up tonight and put the Western Province to the sword for a large part of the game. But two yellow cards late on the game, three very quick tries from the Western Province, and suddenly it was game on once again. But the Lions managing to hold on. A brilliant encounter of rugby, a brilliant product of the Currie Cup, and a really good testament to the South African rugby at the moment. I thought it was a fantastic collision. Real proper nail biter, edge of the seat stuff, and it was made for a very stressful, but very, very enjoyable game. Before we break down the game itself and exactly what sort of transpired, please do smash a like on the video, subscribe to the channel as well if you are new. Right, so it was the perfect try for the start for the Lions, who scored in the 6th minute through 20-year-old Sibo Siso Sangweni, who I reckon could be up there for man of the match. He was absolutely terrific. Fred Zeilinger missed the conversion, and 14 minutes later, Rabs McClanner, who I thought was also very good, went over for the Lions' second try after sucking a lot of players in towards the right-hand side. They then went off to the left, and Rabs McClanner strolled over for what was quite an easy finish by the end of it. Fred Zeilinger also missing the conversion, which kind of came back to bite the Lions, almost came back to bite the Lions in the end. The Western Province hit back after a very good passage of play through Jano Augustus, who muscled his way over the try line in the 19th minute. Tim Sweel nailing that conversion, but the Lions hit back almost immediately, sort of 5 minutes later, through PJ Buerta. This time, Fred Zeilinger splitting the poles to make it 17-7. But in the 28th minute, the Western Province got a penalty inside the Lions territory, and Tim Sweel nailed it. And then it was the yellow card of Evan Ruiz, which started almost opened the floodgates. He was sent off in the 38th minute, a very poor penalty for him to give away, and I think because the Western Province had given quite a few penalties away and they were on their final warning, and Evan Ruiz then just dove over a ruck and played the scrum off. I mean, it was a bit ludicrous by him. And after that, as I said, the floodgates really did open. Ruben Schoeman went over on the brink of halftime in the 39th minute. Fred Zeilinger getting the conversion to make it 24 points to 10 at halftime. After halftime, PJ Buerta opened the scoring in the second half very early in the 43rd minute. Fred Zeilinger nailing the conversion before Rasmus McClanner also went over with an intercept try in the 47th minute. He scored a brace tonight. Fred Zeilinger nailing the conversion as well. So by the time Evan Ruiz came back on the field, it had gone from being 37 points to 10 to being 38 points to 10. And by that sort of stage, you'd think it was all be done. But the Western Province did very, very well. They brought in a couple of big players, Sally Sunday, who had a very nice run out for a change, Jason Alexander. And they pretty much set up camp in the Lions 22 for about 10 to 15 minutes. And the Lions gave away quite a few penalties. And the ref warned them. He said to Frank Horn, the captain of the Lions, listen, you know, it's a similar situation to Evan Ruiz. If you continue conceding penalties, you will see a man go to the bin. And luckily, they managed to sort of get away out of that after a brilliant turnover by Sangweni. So it looked like that was it. You know, the Lions had done enough. But after a brilliant break by the Western Province, Jakub Isaki was sent to the bin in the 67th minute after conceding a penalty, what was deemed to be a professional foul. And literally a minute later, off the lineout, the Western Province then won a penalty with Ruben Schoeman deemed to have come from the side and was immediately sent off. Which I think is a little bit harsh because I think that they had lots of opportunity earlier to send somebody off and they didn't. But then we're very quick to send off Jakub Isaki after that, which is apparently a professional foul, so it's fine. But then the very next infringement was immediately a yellow card. So I think it's a little bit harsh. I think that especially if you look at the infringement itself, you know, if it's a deliberate knockdown and stuff like that, I can go with it. But yeah, I suppose, you know, you can't afford to give all those penalties away in the danger area. So Ruben Schoeman went to the bin. And after that, it was carnage. It was absolute carnage. It was a penalty try literally a minute later with the Lions down to 30 men. They couldn't defend the scrum. Off the kickoff, a brilliant try by Paul DeVette. I mean, literally, it was so easy. The Lions kicking it deep, and the Western Province just went to the blind side and found an overlap inside ball. They went over, and literally 2 minutes later, Cornell Smith went over. And that was because the Lions won possession back, needed to try and wind down 6 or 7 minutes, but for some reason kicked over the top. And when you think that the Western Province were finding space pretty much everywhere, why would you give away the possession? But they did, and Cornell Smith made it count. This time, Tim Sweel missing the conversion. And in the 76th minute, with the Lions still down to 13 men, the Western Province decided to go for 3 points after winning a penalty, which Tim Sweel nailed. And it was, to be fair, it was probably the right decision if they wanted to win the game. You know, they were a try away. They were more than a try away. So, you know, that three-pointer would have meant they could have scored in the last sort of 4 or 5 minutes to try and win the game. But the two players came back on the field in the 77th and 78th minutes. And thankfully for the Lions, some very good defending and very heroic defending. Jakob Asaki was one of the men who was set off, managed to pull off a steal right towards the end, well into extra time, to win a penalty and the game for the Lions. So, it was, as I said, it was an absolute brilliant encounter. If we look at the stats, very, very even. 48% for the Lions, 52% for the Western Province. It was off in the second half, really. Western Province had 61% of the possession in the second half. Territory also 59% in the second half. Overall was 49-51 in favor of the Western Province. 6 tries to 4, 10 tries in the match, 4 conversions to 2, 2 penalties kicked by the Western Province, none by the Lions. 497 meters run by the Western Province, of which I reckon about 200 of them was in that passage of play in the last sort of 10 minutes. 280 meters run by the Lions. 26 defenders beaten by the Western Province, the 16 of the Lions. 5 clean breaks by Western Province, 8 from the Lions. A lot more passes from the Western Province, 138. The handling was very good today, I must admit. The handling was very good, and that's why they were scoring those tries. Because they were just, you know, we've seen games where teams have managed 13 men quite well. But what the Western Province did very well is that they just used their hands. You know, they went through their hands quickly. You know, suck in a defender, go one. Suck in a defender, go one. And you're going to create that overlap every single time. And that's maybe where other teams have gotten it wrong when they're playing against 13 men. Sometimes just not, you know, just doing the basics, drawing a man. You know, one on one on one, there will always be a two-man overlap. Turnovers won with 3 each. Kicks from hand, 30 from the Lions, 21 from the Western Province. If we look at tackles made, the Lions had made 112 of 139 tackles, whereas the Western Province made 108 of 125. The goal kick success rate almost came back to bite the Lions, 67%. And I think that, you know, had the Lions not won the game, you know, I think you look at those 2 misconversions from Fred Zeilinger, and I think he definitely should have gotten one. And, you know, 40 points to 32 is a whole different game. So I think that those conversions are very important. You've got to make your kicks. 100% success, ruck success rate for the Lions, 94 for the Western Province, 86% line-out success rate for the Lions. They lost one right at the end where all they had to do was win the line-out and they could have kicked the ball out and they lost it. 89% line-out success rate for the Western Province, 86% scrum success for the Lions, 83% scrum success for the Western Province. Lions conceded a lot of penalties. That's something that they did. A lot of penalties. They're going to have to look after that discipline, but I don't think they're going to be complaining in the slightest. Some very impressive players for me from the Lions. I thought Raz Bakwana must be in line for man of the match, scoring 2 tries, running 30 meters, beating 2 defenders, 4 clean breaks, made 7 tackles, 1-2 turnovers as well. I thought he was absolutely terrific. I thought Sibasiso Sangweni worked tirelessly. 3 carries, but he made 12 tackles. 1 turnover. Decent run as well. Virgil Tuka was absolutely immense, as he always is. 11 carries, 14 tackles, just 1 missed tackle, an offload, a clean break, 2 defenders beaten, 63 meters run. As I said, get him into that bot camp as soon as possible because he is a really good player. For the Western Province, I thought Dan Dupacier had quite a good game. He ran quite a few meters, 44 meters gained, 1 defenders beaten, 1 clean break, 10 tackles, 2 missed. Sergio Peterson was somebody who I thought grew into the game. He ran 57 meters by the end of the game. 4 offloads, 2 defenders beaten, and a clean break as well. In the Western Province pack, I thought Evan Ruiz was characteristically full of running. Made 11 carries, 13 tackles, 78 meters run, 4 passes, 7 defenders beaten, 1 clean break, 1 offload. Didn't miss a single tackle either. He was very, very good. It was just a very good contest, you know. A proper, you know, carry cup clash where it could have gone either way, and both sides, if they'd won the game, would have deserved it. I think the Lions do their best at throwing it away in many ways, but the Western Province, you still have to take your opportunities and make your opportunities count. So they were very, very good in that regard, in that when they went down to 13 men, they played brilliantly. You know, you could just see they had a whole new energy and they really pushed the Lions right to the end. But this is what the Currie Cup's all about. It's about the Lions losing with a bonus point, going on to beat the Western Province. You know, the Western Province coming off a bonus point victory, they weren't particularly good against the Bulls, and they weren't particularly good for about 65 minutes of tonight's game. So quite a few question marks over that Western Province side, but resilience-wise, top-notch. You know, to be able to sort of sniff blood and be able to run in 3 tries in sort of 4 minutes to try and create a game out of it, you have to give them a lot of credit. But by then, it was too late. So, you know, the 38 points is what killed them, as opposed to not being able to score in the last sort of 10 minutes. So lots of work to be done for Western Province. For the Lions, the last time they'll actually play a Currie Cup game until the 10th of July. They now go into a bye bubble ahead of the British and Irish Lions series. So you won't see them in the Currie Cup anytime soon. But a fantastic way for them to sign off. Let me know what you thought of the game down below. Smash like on the video. Do subscribe to the channel. My name is Steven. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll chat to you guys all very soon.